minutes long, so Connors will now be serving at 3-4.
3-4.
Jimmy is looking around. I think someone made a comment during play there, which can be very distracting.
From time to time throughout this turn, we've had a spectator holler out or fault or something, which has thrown the players off. I'm sure that's what they're hoping will not happen here.
Connor serves 3-4. Absolute packed house. Very, very quiet, and at the moment, very tense.
First to reach 7 with a 2-point advantage will win the set. Pancho Segura shaking his head. No, and it's now set point for Borg. As a matter of fact, he has 2 set points. Close to reaching over the net to make contact. He did not do so. It is still set point for Borg with Connor serving at 5-6.
Keep in mind also sets are 1-1.
Getting nervous myself now.
Maybe that's why my palms are wet. Connor's taking his time, trying to collect himself.
Tiebreaker, third set. Sets for 1-1.
Ace, that's 6 points all.
And now Borg
7,
will serve.
6, Connors.
What some people call lingering death. They used to use a 9-point sudden death tiebreaker. When you got the 4-all, it was set point or match point for both.
It's
Bjorn with his serve to come. Best approach shot you could possibly hit.
Yes, you do. And that crowd feedback certainly helps.
Set point for Connors.
10-9, Connors. First to 7, you might remember. Win by 2. The win's the tiebreaker. But you have to win by 2.
Hitting the backhand especially a lot harder than he was early in the match.
There are no clouds overhead, so that makes depth perception that much more difficult. How a ball's been struck by the sound.
We're located very close to LaGuardia and Kennedy Airport.
Back live in its deuce. And break point for Connors. It's 2-2 in the fourth set.
Sets are 2-1. Connors.